Galactic Date 20XX. At the far reaches of space lies a planet on the brink of ruin. The planet's name? Kopai. Due to a booming population, booming appetites, and a basic lack of planning, Kopai's inhabitants have all but exhausted their food supply. Their only hope is to find another planet with edible matter. Accordingly, they send unmanned scout vessels called Sparrows out into space. To their dismay, the search is proving fruitless. Just as they're about to give up, the final vessel reports back with news of a miraculous discovery. They mobilize to investigate the planet, which they name PNF-404. Kopai's last hope rests on three intrepid explorers. At last, the explorer's 279,000 light-year voyage nears its end. But as they initiate the landing sequence, something goes horribly wrong.
Exploration, day one, 8:44 a.m. Charlie's crash site.
Whoa.
Ugh.
Super, super.
What happened? Where am I? The last thing I remember was... Of course, this must be PNF-404.
Sorry.
Charlie's ship, do you copy? This is your captain. I repeat, do you copy? Hello? Anyone? There's no response. Where's my ship? My crew? Captain Charlie. I managed to escape unscathed. But what about the rest of my crew? They could be anywhere on PNF-404. I'm about to find Alf and Brittany. I only hope they survived. And hello everybody, Ghibli Mihao here. This is Pikmin 3. Real quickly before we get started, this is actually my first Pikmin game I've ever played. Yeah, I'm late to the game. I have purchased Pikmin 2 for the Wii, and I was gonna play that to get ready for this. I bought it about a week ago, but unfortunately, I just never found time to play it. I'm not too depressed about, I guess. I kind of wanted to go into this blind to the series, so that's good. Just like the SS Drake having problems, so did my recording software. So we're gonna try day one once again, but that's not a problem. It's good. So, without further ado, let's go explore this planet. I must say the music in this game is just fantastic. It's visually stunning. What in the? What are these things? No matter. There are more of them. This planet's mushrooms are huge! Heh heh heh. I seem to have wandered into a strange neighborhood. That one's all posing. Why are they coming closer? Whistle will scare them off. I'm surrounded. Maybe I should throw them. Why won't these guys stop hovering over me? They don't appear hostile. So let me get this straight. I can round these creatures up by pointing at them and pressing ZR and throw them with A. Finally, I can dismiss the whole group with B. These fellas can be of some use. So really, just on the Wii U gamepad right now, it just shows a picture of Charlie, says Charlie, and that's all. Right now, anyway. But let's get rid of these mushrooms. And that's how it's done. I got two more in my party. You destroy that. So if you look at the bottom right quickly, you'll see it says squad/field. So I guess there's 30 Pikmin in the field. Oh, hey, wait a minute. I wonder. I can get these guys. Nice. So on your squad is how many are following you right now. And on the field is obviously how many are actually, well, on the field. So we got 20 out of 30 right now, which is, I don't know, which is not really that important right now, but it will be. And it's good to know to that. This game. All the sound effects and stuff, everything is well done. I should look around for my crew. Pressing ZL will let me see what's in front of me. So it centers the camera behind you. Or just centers the camera in the screen, I guess. Camera controls really well. Hey, there's some more Pikmin. Look, there's even more of them. There's all 30. Do note that you can use the, what enormous mushrooms. Stop interrupting me, Charlie. So it's pretty much as fast as you can tap A is pretty much as fast as you'll throw them. But you can use the Wiimote and Nunchuck to play this. I'm guessing just as it controlled in the Wii U version of Pikmin. But I'm using the Wii U gamepad because, well, I've never played Pikmin before, and, well, I want to play it this way. Without further ado, let's go in this cave. Oh, this game. It blows my mind. These guys sure are dedicated. You guys are, aren't you? Follow me. What are those things? They look dangerous. Wow, what's that? Wow, that's bright. Slice is chasing away those things. What's that? Uh-oh, the Pikmin took off. Oh jeez. Exploration, day one, 8:46 a.m., Elf's Crash Site. So, unlike the first, two games, it doesn't follow Olimar, this follows three new captains. We've seen Charlie already, this is Elf, and Brittany's been, well, talked about, but not seen yet. There's the SS Drake. Just putting her along. Oh, it looks like it might have crashed. This game looks fantastic. It's a miracle. I'm alive and somehow unharmed. Elf. Just as the SS Drake was about to land, we lost control and had to make an emergency escape. During the chaos, I was separated from my other two team members, as well as the ship itself. As the ship's engineer, it's up to me, Elf, to find both the SS Drake and my crew members. Did you hear the music there? That music, it makes me quiver. I like it so much. It's that music. I don't know. It does something to me. What was that? Yeah, everything about this game is just so fantastic. Visually, the music, everything. I'm not gonna be able to stop talking about it because it's just so good. Little guy. It appears that this specimen I just spotted has company. And what's that stuck in that branch? Is there anything I can do? They respond to the whistle. What friendly little guys. Just need to throw one more. Nice! And that is the Pikmin's home, also known as the Onion. I was hoping that it was fruit, but it doesn't appear to be edible at all. Nevertheless, the red fellow seemed quite pleased now that it's freed. Hey, they're following me. Come with me, and you'll see a world of pure imagination. What are they doing? Come here, buddy. That little Pikmin's a secret little guy to sit in there. Here, you grab one. So I don't know, I can't remember if they did this in the other Pikmin games. I've never played them, but I have seen LPs of them. They're carrying single pieces and they're throwing them into place. I think that's so cool. Look at that. My Copad! Thank goodness I found it! I can use it to locate the SS Drake! As soon as we can get over there. Bridge isn't built yet. The dishes are not done. Those guys are carrying that stuff around. We'll take a little look-see around here. Of course, there's nothing that much we can do right now. But yeah, this... Oh, listen to that music! And listen to them, like, their little chants as they're walking. Yeah, you could use some more helpers, you're right. You carry that stuff, yo. Oh, everything. This game. I really like Studio Ghibli. And this game really feels like Studio Ghibli to me. I don't know why, the music, everything. Oh, there we go, the bridge is complete. The dishes are now down. Come here, buds. Wonderful, the bridge is complete. Let's go pick up our Copad. That's a big camera. Look at the Wii U gamepad. So if you look at the Wii U gamepad, it's identical to what you see on the screen there. Great, it still works, of course. I was expecting nothing less from the Copate engineering. I'll check my surroundings by tapping and sliding the Copad screen. Where's the Drake? Aha, the SS Drake isn't that far from here. Maybe the other two crew members are there as well. I'd best head in that direction. So yeah, looking at the... You see in the screen of the Copad there? That's exactly what you see in the screen of the Wii U gamepad. It's a map. And it works just like it should. So you go ahead and grab that. You grab that. And you grab that. And we'll follow these guys back to our ship. Or no, back to their ship. Their home, the Onion. We'll get a little cutscene here. With that, it sprouts some more Pikmin. That thing is popping out with some sort of sprouts. Red Pikmin. Aha, I see. So this is how these little creatures propagate. How incredibly fascinating. So as Elf here just explained to us, we're missing one, there it is. Those little pellets with the numbers on them, if you ever played a Pikmin game, those are the nutrients from the plants or from whatever we, whatever pops them out. So these little guys propagate, as he just said, with those nutrients. So those nutrients will, I don't know, sprout, well, actually sprout three, but Destroy these guys. Kill them. There we go. So you, buddy, can take this one back with you. You can take that back with you. Use the remaining 5 Pikmin up here. Whoa, that's... I'm gonna fall. To take this big flower back. So this is a 5 nutrient pellet. Let those guys work on that. So right now we have 14 on the field. Look in the bottom right again, that shows your totals and everything. And we'll just pick these Pikmin here. And the enemies that we killed, we brought them to the end, and they also sprout those enemies, the smaller ones. I don't know if all the enemies are the same, but the smaller ones gave us 1 Pikmin each, so. You carry that pellet. Oh, well, I could have put more Pikmin on that pellet too, and it would have carried it faster, but I'm not that smart. Okay. So that 5 will give us 5. That gives us 21 Pikmin, which is 1 more than we need to move this box. What is this enormous thing? That Drake must be somehow on the other side of it. Pikmin, move that box! Give us our 20 Pikmin. Push that box out of the way. And what is this? What's that? Looks like someone's left a data file here. Perhaps the co-pad will be able to read it. So again, the Wii U gamepad is mimicking exactly what's on the co-pad on the screen right now. So that's the screen inside the screen, you know, screenception. The Pikminology number 1 is shown exactly the same on the Wii U gamepad. The onion is nest for the Pikmin. It both gives birth to them and provides them a shelter. Excellent! The co-pad can read the data file. So these creatures are called Pikmin. This information might come in handy later on. I'll save it in the co-pad's exploration notes. Installing. Exploration notes. I don't think Captain Charlie wrote this data file. So who did? Could there be other intelligent life forms on this planet? So it makes me wonder, do they know about, what's his name? Olimar? And his Louis, I think, is his friend's name. According to the radar, Drake should be through here. In this cave. Some nasty mushrooms. Wow, those are massive, but they don't look edible. Nope, they'll just poof into disgusting smoke. So we'll get our 21 Pikmin here to break down this wall. Who built this wall here? More signs of intelligent life? That's a good question. My crew could have learned a lot from this kind of teamwork. I hope the Drake's okay. There it is, the SS Drake! Looks okay. The co-pad isn't picking up any signs of life in the immediate area. What am I supposed to do now? Incoming transmission. Who could it be? Elf, it's me, Brittany. Do you copy? Thank goodness you're with the SS Drake, right? I made it through the landing in one piece. The thing is, I'm trapped somewhere. And I'm starved. Oh no, we got cut off. I wonder how far Brittany is. But at the very least, I'm thankful she appears to be safe and sound. What's that strange sound? The sun is setting, which could mean that nocturnal predators are starting to wake up. I should probably get off the planet's surface for now. Most of the supplies we brought with us from the Kopai were destroyed in the crash landing. So we now only have 3 days worth of edible provisions left. And you're gonna consume one of them right now, aren't ya? Down to 2. Starting tomorrow, I'll have to find some local food. Day 1. So this will show us our Pikmin count, which is 21 red Pikmin. So far no deaths, that's probably not going to last very long, but hey, there's a replay button on the bottom there. I don't know what that does. It intrigues me, but I'm not going to test it out, because if it replays the whole day, then we don't need to see that, do we? Just replay the video. We'll press A, just continue on. Day 1. We're shipwrecked on this planet. Some creatures called Pikmin helped me find the SS Drake, but of course... But our cosmic drive is nowhere to be found. We won't be going anywhere without that. Luckily, I made contact with Brittany and we'll set out to find her tomorrow. When I took off in the ship, the onion took flight as well. Odd, but amazing. Elf. There's the onion. So the onion actually takes off to keep the Pikmin from danger, from nocturnal predators as well. And we just saved. Exploration, day 2. So we're finished with day 1. We're searching for signals. And the Garden of Hope will be our first, our first little venture. I've tracked down Brittany's signal. Right now, finding her is my highest priority. However, I'm also very concerned that our cosmic drive key is now missing. If I don't find that, then Drake won't be able to fly fast enough to get us back to Kopai. That would be very, very bad. But before we end the video here, this is going to be the end of day 1. I don't know how long the days are in this, so depending on how long the days are, I might just do a video per day. So thank you for joining me for day 1, and I'll see y'all again next time.